Group B streptococcus, or group B strep, is a bacteria that lives in the vaginal tract of healthy adult women. At any given time, up to 30% of women can have group B strep in their vaginal tracts. Normally, it's not a problem. However, during pregnancy, group B strep can infect the neonate in utero, or it could cause infections in human newborns. At least 4 million cases of group B strep have been reported to occur worldwide per year. Currently, there is no vaccine to prevent group B strep infections. Because of this, it remains a global health issue. So group B strep infections typically affect the newborn. If it infects the fetus in utero, then you can get preterm birth or stillbirths because of group B strep. If the infant acquires group B strep from the mother during labor and delivery, then infants typically get pneumonia, sepsis, and in severe cases, meningitis. We don't understand a whole lot about how group B strep is ascending from the vagina into the uterus. We have studied some virulence factors, but we don't completely understand this process. So in this study, we asked, how does group B strep penetrate the vaginal barrier? And this work was performed by a very talented graduate student in my lab, Jay Warnhagen. And what he was able to show is that group B strep causes epithelial cells to exfoliate, or shed, if you will. Typically, this process of shedding is thought to help the mother or the host to prevent vaginal bacteria from colonizing. But for group B strep, what he found was that as the epithelial cells were shed, they caused a loss of barrier function. So the vaginal cell or the epithelial cell layer became more permeable, if you will, became slightly more porous, if you can imagine that. So this way, the bacteria now was able to penetrate these vaginal cells and gain access to deeper tissue. What we found in our study is that group B strep will stimulate integrin signaling or activate integrins. When this happens, there are three proteins that get phosphorylated and thereby triggers a signaling cascade. These three proteins are FAK, AKT, and GSK3 beta. Therefore, when this signaling cascade is activated, beta-catenin is stabilized and translocated into the nucleus. Once beta-catenin is translocated into the nucleus, it will activate transcription of a number of beta-catenin-regulated genes. When that occurs, a process known as epithelial to mesenchymal transition occurs, whereby epithelial cells become more motile. This leads to epithelial exfoliation. However, it also leads to a loss of barrier function in the vaginal cells. Group B strep takes advantage of this loss of barrier function and gains access to deeper tissues, invading deeper vaginal tissues, invading deeper uterine tissues, and ultimately the fetus. Therefore, there is increased risk of group B strep ascending infection and adverse pregnancy outcomes. So one of the things that came out from this study is that GBS induces epithelial exfoliation that leads to loss of barrier function in the vagina. So if one of the things we can try to do is to find ways where we can prevent group B strep induced loss of barrier function. So if we can find reagents or vaccines or treatment options where we can prevent GBS induced loss of barrier function or even prevent GBS colonization of the vagina in the first place, then we can significantly reduce GBS infections to human babies. So this research was primarily spearheaded by my very talented graduate student, Jay Warnhagen. In addition, many people from my lab that included other graduate students and postdocs also helped Jay perform some of the experiments. We have two collaborators that also contributed significantly to this work. Some of them were from the University of Washington, and another collaborator is at University of Colorado in Denver. So it was a large team of people that contributed to these novel findings.